Hello everyone, this is the first chapter of the Excelize tutorials, section 3. To better understand the concept in coming up this tutorial, I will introduce some concepts first in this part and introduce what kinds of spreadsheet documents format was supported by Excelize, and compare Excelize with some similar spreadsheet open source libraries in this section. At last, I will give 4 examples of using Excelize to show you how to quick start to use. First, you need to know some concepts of the Excel. There are 6 parts. Open the Excel application. Here is the user interface of the Excel application. The Excel document is basically composed of these small rectangles on the screen. Each of these rectangles we call a cell. Cells can be used to store data or set a formula. In addition, it has a very important feature that each cell has a specific reference position, just like the coordinates on the map. For example, the reference position of this cell is D5, and the reference position of this cell is the F7. Each Excel document is a workbook, and this workbook is named Book 1. Each workbook can contain multiple worksheets. When we create a new workbook, we create a worksheet named Sheet 1 by default. The same default worksheet will be created when using Excelize to create a workbook. Let's take a look at the common file extensions of Excel. Generally, the file extension for normal workbooks is XLSX, while XLSM is for workbooks with macros. XLTX is an Excel template document, and the XLTM file is a template with macros. Excelize are compatible with many spreadsheet applications, such as the Microsoft Office Excel, Apple Numbers, KingSoft WPS Office, Apache OpenOffice, LibreOffice, and the spreadsheet documents generated by online office applications such as Google Sheets also can be read and written by Excelize library. The following table lists some open source spreadsheet document library of the popular programming languages for your information. Next, I will show you a performance benchmark report of generating the same amount of data spreadsheet documents for these open source libraries. The following report is based on the performance of a common personal computer generating 50 columns and 102,400 rows of plain text cells, over 5 million cells in this benchmark. The left figure shows the time cost, the right figure is the memory usage. The performance report of Excelize is based on the version 2.6.0 and uses the Excelize streaming function for generating the spreadsheet documents with amount of data will be get better performance. It can be faster and use less memory than Excelize normal functions. I will introduce use which one of these two kinds of function in different scenarios in the later section of this course. And at this time, I will introduce some things to Excelize you need to know. There are many ways you can be flexible in integrating the Excelize library into your service. You can read and write to a spreadsheet document with the function provided by Excelize, and you can open an existing workbook, modify or append data in it, and save into the workbook, or let the workbook as the template use the function provided by Excelize to save as a new workbook. If you want to make your service support importing or exporting Excel documents, you can transform between any custom data structure and the Excelize API requirements format easily, which allows the processing of the spreadsheet document in memory and doesn't touch the disk file system. In addition, Excelize provided a streaming API for generating or reading data from a worksheet with huge amounts of data. Please visit the official document website for get performance benchmark report for each released version. The following table shows the Go language version requires of each version of the Excelize library. I strongly suggest you to using the latest stable released version. Next, I will show you for simple demo for quick start using the Excelize library. First, open the official document website of the Excelize. Open the basic usage page and copy the first example code for creating an Excel document. Then open the Visual Studio Code Editor, create a directory named 1.3 in the tutorials directory, create a source code file with the Go extension, and paste the example code just copied, and save the source code as main.go. Open the terminal, Run go mod init command creates a new module rooted at the current directory, and run go mod tidy adds any missing module requirements necessary to build the current module's package as dependencies. Okay, now run go run man.go command, you will get a new workbook named book1.xlsx. Open the workbook by Excel application to check the sales value. Let me explain the source code. You have to create a new workbook with the new file function provided by Excelize at first. It will return the structure variables named f, and call the new sheet function implemented by f to add a new worksheet named sheet2 in the workbook. After that, it returns a new variable index to represent the index of the worksheet you just created. The coming up code will be used this index. Set the sales value by sheet name and the reference after creating the worksheet. Call the setSaleValue function to set the sales value. And you can see the program set the D2 sales value on sheet 1 to 100 by setSaleValue function at here. And then set the A2 sales value in the sheet 2 to hello world. And then call the setActiveSheet function to set the default worksheet when opening the workbook. Call the saveAs function to save the workbook as book1.xlsx at last. Okay, now I will show you how to read the existing Excel document by Excelize. Turn back to the Excelize documentation, copy the example of the reading Excel document to the source code. Save the source code and run the program. You can see the sales value of the worksheet has been printed out in the terminal. In this example, open the existing Excel document by open file function provided by Excelize. And then you can read the cell value by getCellValue function with the worksheet name and cell reference. In addition, the getRows function can be fetching the all of the cells value on a specific worksheet. You need to receive and check every error value returned by functions for the reliability for your program. The third example is about how to create a native graphic chart in a worksheet like this. Copy the example source code in the editor, save the source code and run the program. And it will generate a new workbook named book1.xlsx. Open it by Excel application, and you can see there a chart based on the worksheet data has been created. Let's take a look about the source code. First, declare two chart data variables, categories and values, and then traverse these two variables to prepare the chart data range sales value. Using the addChart function to create a native chart, there are three required parameters: worksheet name, sales reference, and chart properties. You can specify the chart type, the data range, chart title, and any more of chart in the chart properties. Then save the workbook by saveAs function. The last example is how to insert a picture in the Excel document. I have prepared an image in the project directory. Open the documentation website and copy the code of the example about adding the picture to the Excel document in the editor. Because I just inserted a PNG format image here, so just need to import the PNG format library and then insert the image by the addPicture function provided by Excelize, and specify the cell reference and the path of the image file here. In addition, change the zoom scale of the image in the image property parameter. 0.1 represents scaling to 10% of original image size. Delete unless code, save the source code, and run the program. Open the generated spreadsheet documents by Excel application to check the result. You can see the image has been inserted into the A5 cell of the worksheet. Okay, that's it for this video. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please comment below. And welcome to subscribe and ring the bell so you can get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching and thanks for your choosing Excelize.